I think to get the juices going, we did do some stuff on diet last week. Lizzie, I believe this week you've got a quiz for us.
I do, actually, because I was doing a little bit of research on food and diet, and I found on the British Heart Foundation, really nice website, lots of information, as you would imagine, about eating healthily, how to eat healthily on a budget. And there's a really nice quiz that I thought we could do, and it's about food labelling.
Food labelling?
Yeah.
Okay.
And do we understand what's in our foods?
Okay, we're not good at labelling on this show. We try and resist labelling
right.
on this show.
But it's more about what's in foods.
I'm joking. Crack on. Okay. So last week we talked about the importance of diet. If you eat rubbish, basically you'll feel rubbish. The stuff that was done, the film about the bloke who only ate McDonald's for a month and what it did to his body, and the importance of balanced diets and fruit and oily fish and nuts. And I think I might have talked about broccoli for a little while.
Yes, you did.
How bizarre was that? So, Lizzie.
Yes.
Or shall I call you Bamba Gascoigne this evening?
if you like.
Crack on with the quiz then, and we'll have a look at food. Are we answering the questions as we go
along?
Yeah,
shall we? Or shall I hand out pieces of paper? I can do both.
Nope.
I'm multitasking this evening.
No, crack on. We'll go through it. So,
this is just a quick food labelling quiz, just to see whether we know what's in our food, what we're eating. So the first question was, we know that the most important meal of the day is the breakfast. So which breakfast is the highest in calories? Is it a frosted cereal, a cereal bar, or a croissant? Which is the highest
in sugar?
In calories.
Calories.
Mm.
Ooh. Because croissants are usually got butter in them.
Loads of butter, yeah.
I'd go for cereal bar because it's full of sugar and syrup and nuts, probably.
Okay.
I'm a croissant person, I think.
Yeah. Chilli, what do you reckon? No, you can't look at the answer. That's cheating.
Is sugar's empty calorie? I don't know.
It's just a high in calorie.
I'm going croissant.
Croissant, yeah.
Cereal bar.
It is actually a cereal bar. Yeah. Well done, Jeanette.
Well to Jeanette.
Okay, we know that fruit and vegetables make a good snack.
So what you're saying is, in terms of breakfast, cereal bars, not good.
Yeah, actually really high in calories.
Okay, so coffee and cigarettes, is that all right?
What do you think?
I think probably.
Scrambled tofu.
Okay, presumably it should be something like porridge. You were talking about porridge last week, weren't you?
That's right,
and the benefits of porridge and the slow release and all that. Bit of fruit, bit of yogurt, something. Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
Totally good.
We know it. So we also know that fruit and veg are good snacks, but what about other tempting foods?
Good snacks?
Sounds really
no, absolutely.
Yeah,
no, chocolate.
We do
chocolate's
know these guys. So out of these, which has the most saturated fat?
Brazil nuts.
Is it a currant bun, a flapjack, or a digestive biscuit? Highest in saturated fat.
Flapjack.
Digestive biscuit.
Okay.
Peer pressure flapjack. What was it? Digestive flapjack or currant bun?
Currant bun.
Ooh. I think it might be a currant bun.
It is, in fact, a flapjack.
Oh,
so well done, guys.
Jeanette and Julie.
Yes, yeah.
Okay,
so
good.
Next,
right.
Grabbing a sandwich.
So we shouldn't be eating flapjacks?
No, we're not saying we shouldn't, but obviously, depending on what you're having during the day, you've got to look at evening that out, maybe.
Okay, fair enough.
If you're going on a long walk, maybe, a flapjack is perfect.
It's very good.
It depends the shape as well, doesn't it?
As well. I know
yes.
when... yeah, no, triangular
fright. Yeah.
When we did the Five Nations bike ride, flapjacks were brilliant for the cyclists because they were full of calories and whatever else. If you're cycling 100 miles a day, you can pretty much eat what you want.
Yeah.
Brilliant.
So, next question. Grabbing a sandwich for lunch is an easy option, but which of these sandwiches has the least salt content? Is it cheese and coleslaw, chicken Caesar, or egg and cress? Which has the least salt?
Egg and cress.
What were they again?
You've got cheese and coleslaw.
Coleslaw. Nice.
Chicken Caesar or egg and cress?
I'll go with egg and cress as well.
Okay. Is that consensus of opinion? Yeah?
I'm going to go for chicken.
It is, in fact, the chicken.
Chicken Caesar?
Yeah.
Really?
I actually thought egg and cress would be...
Egg and cress sounds
reasonably
healthy.
Yeah, it's really healthy, doesn't it? But no, it's
horrible,
chicken
but
Caesar.
Healthy.
And I guess chicken Caesar on its own, so not with loads of, you know, salad cream, etc., etc. But, OK, so that's a good one for our least salt.
OK.
So most of us are eating too much saturated fat. Which has the highest unsaturated fat? So is it raspberry cheesecake, sausage roll, or a cheese feast pizza? Which has the highest unsaturated fat?
Highest unsaturated fat?
Yeah.
Raspberry
cheesecake, sausage roll, or the mighty cheese feast pizza?
Cheesecake.
Cheesecake.
Yeah?
Yeah.
It's the cheese feast pizza.
Really?
Yeah.
I thought that was going to be the biggest thing, so there's going to be more in it.
Absolutely, yeah. Okay.
These are really good questions, actually,
aren't
they?
They are really good questions. Yeah. They do make you think, yeah.
Last one.
Okay,
ready meals, quick and easy, but do we know what's in them? Which has the lowest saturated fat? So is it a shepherd's pie?
No.
Tagliatelle carbonara?
No.
Lasagna?
No. They're all rubbish.
If you had to choose one ready meal, Steve, which would be the lowest saturated fat?
The first one.
I did the box.
Yeah. I think the first one, the cottage pie, is probably lowest.
Yeah, it's the shepherd's pie. Yeah.
There you go. Yeah. Oh, OK. Hey,
well
finally
done.
Finally got one.
But okay. I thought that was really interesting because it really made you think about fats and everything else, not just about calories.
Definitely. I mean, I think we all know that if you only eat chocolate and burgers and all of those unhealthy, the highly calorific things...
You'd be really happy.
You'd be happy, but maybe, unless you're doing a lot of exercise, you will put on weight. And I think we put so much emphasis on weight. And there was a lovely programme on the telly the other day. I can't remember what it was. Something about, you know, health and the myths around health. And they took 15 people and measured things like BMI.
Yeah.
But then measured body fat ratio and then measured how healthy they were in terms of exercise and breathing and whatever else. And actually BMI and healthiness are not necessarily conducive. You know, I'm going to share a bit here about me. My name's Steve and I'm addicted to cigarettes. I smoke far too much. It's the one real vice I have left. And I know, I'm relatively slim, my BMI is perfectly within the safe limits, my diet's not bad, I don't drink excessively, you know, I'm relatively healthy, other than the fact that I smoke. And I know that that just knackers me in terms of health. It's the one thing that we can all do to make ourselves healthy. But again, in terms of diet, my diet's not bad, but I do occasionally pig out on... Most of the things that you've just said are the worst for me, Lizzie. So there you go. Really good quiz. So that was British Heart Foundation?
Yeah, British Heart Foundation. Really good website. Lots of information. Yeah.
So it's not just about calories. It's about saturated fats.
Yeah, it's about looking
salt,
at everything on those
it's
labels.
About, it's
yeah.
about all of the nutrients that we all need to keep our heads in a good place. I was there was a thing about your brain, and your brain's made up of omega oils as well as water and all of those sort of things. And omega oils are oily fish and some nuts and pulses and that sort of stuff. Sorry?
Linseed.
There you go. And the importance of having that in your diet. And I think those are things that you kind of don't necessarily think about when you think about a healthy diet. You think about cucumber and celery and rocket. Rocket is properly nice, by the way. It's like lettuce, but with flavour. So it's all of those things that we... sorry, that joke is copyright Jeanette, I believe. So yeah, have a think about what you're putting in your body, because what you put in your body will have an impact on how you feel. Lizzie, thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Hi, this is Andrew Ackerman inviting you to join me for Groove Lounge every Thursday night between 10 and 12 a.m. on Seclo Sounds, playing the very best in smooth jazz and soul. Groove Lounge on Seclo Sounds and TuneIn Radio.
While I'm wide-eyed and I'm so down, caught in the middle. I've excused you for a while I'm wide-eyed and I'm so down, caught in the middle. Turn a blind eye with a stare caught right in the middle. Have you wondered for a while? I have a feeling deep down you're caught in the middle. If a line was, would you? While I'm wide-eyed and I'm so damn caught in the middle.
So what we're proposing this evening is that we're going to have the quiz. I'm going to ask you the questions. We're going to then discuss schizophrenia. And then at the end of the show, we'll revisit the quiz and see what we've learned this evening. I know, yes. Yeah, this is proper audience participation. So for those of you that don't have access to Facebook, I'm going to run through the questions. We'll have a look at them, see what we think early doors. And then we'll have the discussion, play some songs, have a little natter. Have a look at the Stand Up For Schizophrenia thing, and then we'll come back towards the end of the show and have a look at what the reality is. So,
he's good, isn't he?
It's like doing a pub quiz. All right, ladies and gentlemen, get your points in at the bar. Okay, round one. Can you imagine going to a pub quiz? Round one, schizophrenia.
Yep, bang up for now.
All right, sweet as. Right, okay, so question one. These are yes or no answers. It's really quite simple. If you don't know, just tick don't know. So, question one. People with schizophrenia have multiple personalities. You see what I've done here, you see? OK, question two. People with schizophrenia are more likely to be violent than the general population.
Good one, Steve.
You see? Don't just throw this stuff together, you know? Question three. More men than women are diagnosed with schizophrenia. This is one that quite often gets people. OK, question four. Schizophrenia is caused by poor social conditions.
Oh, I like this thinking radio time.
I'll tell you, mate.
It's all happening. Yeah,